this time?
Okay, this time, let's say we have an unknown again. And now we have three numbers on this side.
We have three numbers? How do we do this?
So now what numbers do we have?
A 4 and a 9 and a 6.
Correct. So now let's say we remove the 6. It's still too heavy.
And the 6 is too heavy.
Now let's try getting it. Okay, so now that was wrong. So now let's try getting rid of 6 and
it's the same thing!
No, 4. No, this is still too light. I mean.
Oh, okay.
Okay, now let's try getting rid of 9. Then 3. It's the same! So what is 4 plus 6?
Wait. 1 minute. Okay, that's it. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. It's 10.
Correct. The unknown number is 10.
Wow. Why don't you teach advanced equations this time? How about you do that?
Hi, everybody. Today we are learning about advanced equations. And let's suppose we have a x squared equals 4. Now, how are we going to remove the square? What is the opposite of square? It's a square root. So then when we do the square root of both sides, the square and the square root cancel out, and the square root of 4 is 2, so x equals 2. And the square never went to the other side. Okay, so now we have x to the power of 3 equals 8. We do the cube root on both sides, they cancel and we get x equals 2 again. So now we are doing the opposite of that. Now the square root of x equals 2. Now, what is the opposite of a square root? It's a square. So we put a square on both sides, cancel, and cancel on the, and then simplify on the other side, and then we get x equals 4. The root never goes and becomes a square. So we only add the square to both sides. When squaring and rooting, we have to be very careful that we square both sides, not everything separately. This example shows what you saw. 1 plus 9 equals 10. Suppose, obviously this is correct. But when we square each and one of them individually, now it becomes wrong. Let's see why. The 1 plus 81 does not equal 100, because 82 does not equal 100. They can't be the same. And here's the correct way of doing it. 1 plus 9 equals 10. We square the whole entire thing. 1 plus 9 equals 10. And then 10 squared equals 10 squared, so 100 equals 100. We can also do it with functions. If you want to know more about functions, I have a link in this description down below to learn more about them. Okay, hey, fx equals 4. We can cancel the fx by putting an f inverse on both sides, because opposite of function is the inverse function. So, function inverse function of x equals inverse function of 4. So, x equals inverse function of 4. Here is an example. Fx equals 2 to the power of x. Finding the inverse of this is quite hard. But if a question was like this, if they had the f inverse, even the f inverse of x is 10, for example, we can just cancel, because we put the f inverse of x on that side. F inverse f x equals f 10, and then x equals f 10, which equals 2 to the power of 10, which equals 1024.
That was such cool advanced equations! You did such a good one! right, but I can do 80 inverse t-quotient right now. Next time, I'm going to do lots of